Hungry for more, Perenara. At the back it comes. Sends it over to Moore. There's lots of room out. Wide, right. It's Barrett to Barrett. They bring the backyard to the biggest stage of all, the Barrett boys. Too good here for Ireland. Full time. The score 46-14.
It's a World Cup quarterfinal. Their last two games were against Samoa and Russia. How have they arrived at this stage that they look shattered?
Why are we this soft language? They lost to Japan, they barely beat Russia, they lost to New Zealand, they didn't get past the last eight. Do you want to call them winners?
Definitely our worst performance of the World Cup, probably our worst performance of 2018, coupled with that warm-up game against England, which was also pretty catastrophic.
Maybe they're not doing enough on the training pitch. You know, maybe they're a bit undercooked, you know, when they reach the heights. They have looked shell-shocked.
This is a thing with Ireland and World Cups where we haven't got the cycle right, where we peak a little bit far out, because it feels like we peaked 6 to 8 months before that.
People probably want me to lambaste the team and go after them individually and personally, and I don't think that's right. The biggest game of their lives and the biggest tournament for a lot of them, and they'll never get the chance again, some of them.
When you end up looking at this game, you end up saying, well, okay, do I look at just today? Do I look at what's happened in the past? Do I look at what's going to happen in the future? And you get caught between all of them. And I think there is a recognition that for some of the players, it's the end of the road. For the coach, it is, because he's moving on. For the captain, he's moving on. They've had phenomenal days in the past in a green jersey. They just didn't have one of those days today.
Events, dear boy, events. Andy Farrell is the new Ireland rugby head coach, has been announced. He'll take over in 2019.
He'll be fantastic for Ireland. He has all the boys' respect already. You know, he's proven how good he is as a coach and how successful he is.
I think Farrell can go and create his own legacy now and take control of the team himself. And I'm very excited about it. I think he is ultimately the best man for the job at the moment.
Could you say any aspect of Ireland's play has improved since his first game in charge? We're not looking for everything to arrive fully formed in his first year in the job, it can't. But, like, we're not seeing improvements.
The word I use is uncertainty, and we don't look very comfortable. There was a huge amount of opportunities and space for us to show what we were capable of, and the lack of certainty or confidence or whatever it is meant we didn't show it.
When you think about the things that have regressed, you know, the quality of passing has been good. Our kicking game has been erratic. At the moment, I just feel as though we're easy to read.
If it is heads of rugby and the players have been given the license to do it, maybe the players haven't the confidence or the willingness to do it.
It's there for Gibson Park. Sexton, Aki, out to Keenan.
We took an eternity to beat New Zealand over a century, and now we've beat them three times in the last 5 years. I'd have to say, I think it's the most complete Irish performance I've ever seen.
Ireland were just ridiculous. It wasn't a fluke. It was a whole different kind of performance from Ireland in terms of attack, ball in hand, the shapes, the confidence that everyone had.
It couldn't have gone better for Ireland. They're continuing to be outstanding.
I've been unsure where Ireland are. I think a lot of people have. One of the best performances that I've seen. I mean, the physicality was unbelievable.
Chicago was a sign Ireland can beat anyone on their day. Dublin is a sign that can beat anyone on any day.
Ireland go them all. The first time they did this, they got advantage. No change. On this occasion, Sheehan breaks away. And the young man is over. Met by another three in Navy.
Lots of penalties.
Gibson Park. Van der Flair. Just Van der Flair. Eventually, the pressure tells. Ireland, the Triple Crown champions for 2022.
Four wins, one loss, 21 points, difference of points of 105. Most years, that's good enough for a title.
You've seen them kind of grow, I think, physically, emotionally, mentally even. They learned lessons in the France game, the Italy game, the Wales game, the England game, and definitely they'll pick up a couple more lessons when they go down New Zealand.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Ireland are going to the hardest place on the planet,
to play a team who are desperate to prove themselves. You go to New Zealand, you win any test, that is a great tour. Australia haven't done it for many, many, many years, and we play them three times a year.
Ireland are good enough to win a game, but everything has to align for them to do that. I'd be surprised if it doesn't end up 3-0.
Now Ringrose, goals, tackled by Simon Rice. They won't stop him. And in the end, it's Arnie Savia who fires it away. Now the little catch run for Cooper. It sits up, and he's in. Scott Barrett making a lot of carries with that number six on his back. And now Arnie Savia busting through. Can he sneak it away? Oh, he doesn't need to. Brilliant try by Arnie Savia. Ireland came looking for their first win in New Zealand, but not here.
Any Irish team that loses by over 40 points, I don't think the narrative's going to be particularly positive.
We looked at bits of the first test and said, this is what we produced. We're not far away.
If we could put our game out there, we'd be in the hunt. We'd be in the hunt.
There was a genuine belief in the squad that we were actually the better team. As crazy as it might seem on the outside, we truly believed it.
Again, the arm goes out. Now, Ireland got the numbers. Charging. Try scored. Boy, what a start that is. Porter stands over it. He's got one already. Has another crack. Oh, he's there. Connor Murray gives it off to Carberry. And a famous Irish victory. Their first against the All Blacks in New Zealand.
Now this is a really good heave. New Zealand treading water and Ireland are through again. James Lowe back in to Hugo Keenan. It's over. Herring. He stretched and he got there. Joey Carberry will kick to touch to end the game. And they have done it.
So Ireland victorious in New Zealand. They join an incredibly exclusive club, maybe the most exclusive club in rugby. South Africa in 1937, Australia 1986, France 1994, and now Ireland 2022.
Irish rugby might have seen its proudest ever day, as they did what nobody has ever done in professional rugby before and defeated New Zealand in a three test series on New Zealand soil.
The idea of winning once in New Zealand was well beyond what Irish rugby could achieve, and to think of how much this country as a rugby force has grown, just knocked off one piece of history after another to become now the world's number one team.
I think they're just getting better and better, and that's the scary thing really. Their attention to detail and the level of execution, the style of play with the ball in hand is just mind-blowing really.
I think Ireland in a great place. I think that, you know, they're number one in the world. I'd say they're 100% favourites to win the Six Nations. I know France are there, but I just think they probably have slightly more with a bit more experience.
Slams are so hard to come by in the Six Nations, but I'm sure this team will feel as though there is a Grand Slam capability there.
The drive forward just held up over the line, but for how much longer? And Ireland have scored. Oh, and the interception comes from Lowe, and Lowe is away, and now we're going to learn just how fast he is.
Time they get into the English 22 at Twickenham. Here's Beale, beautiful ball. Oh, that's magnificent. Keenan's going to score for Ireland. Great work by Ficou. Oh, they're away by Ireland. They are away. Ringrose. Ireland taking a glorious landscape in Dublin.
Ireland have the ball again. Ryan Baird. Ireland building, really building. Matt Hansen out wide. Hansen for the corner.
The English 22. Thunderflare back inside. Sheehan. Gap opens up. Sheehan! This Grand Slam performance. Herring gets it.
This extraordinary group of Irish players have rewritten history yet again.
This is 100% a stepping stone to something much bigger and an opportunity to do something that we genuinely never have, but also feels as though it's within touching distance. A hard route to get there, but it's absolutely achievable.
Blackie has switched the appointment up to the left-hand side. Stockdale, that chip works out. That chip works really well. Stockdale for Ireland. Jacob Stockdale.
Here's Heaslip. Well, he picks it up quickly and off he goes. Drops it off the hinge.
Sexton waits. Here it comes. It looks good. He likes it. Right to Lowen's arm. Goes up.